All right, first we want to start with a template. Press new. 640 by 400 is okay. There you see it appears right there. And then what you want to do is you want to add an alpha channel to this. So you right click on alpha on the layer, and then you add alpha channel. Then over here where you see the eye at, you want to click on that, and that turns it into this checkity type of background, lets you know that it has an alpha channel on it. Then the next thing that you want to do is you want to get your image. I got the image from Google Imaging, and here it is right here, and you just want to drag that over into your project. There it sits right there. Let me put that back up there. And then what you want to do next is you want to resize this. So you take your resizing tool, click on that, then you want to drag this up. You don't necessarily have to make it as big as the screen if you don't want to, but just make it fairly at a decent size. Click scale, then it scales it. And then the next thing you want to do is you want to take your pass tool, which is this one right here, and you want to cut that out. Essentially, that's what you're doing. You're cutting it out. So you click on the pass tool, and then you want to raise it up to as the largest viewing capacity that you want so you can see exactly what you're doing. And then you start to cut it out. And now you want to bring zooming out back to there. And then the next thing you want to do is you want to do select in path. And then you want to control I and then hit delete. And there you have it, all cut out. Then you want to go up there and select done. See, that's all done. And the next thing you want to do is you want to add that picture in the background right there. So you go over to there and you want to drag that into your project right there. There you go. You see it right there. Put that back up there. And what you want to do is you want to put that under. So you just click and hold this and pull it down under it. And you see it goes in behind there. Now you want to take your move tool. And you want to move that image to about where you want it to be. I think that's pretty good. Right there. Like, that's pretty good. Okay, and then you want to resize it. So hit your size tool again. And you want to resize that. You want to get that right at the edge right there. On this side, you can go a little bit past the edge and get it to the point where you won't show any of the corners. I think that's good enough. And hit scale. And as you see, it seems like it's in there right there. And you want to, in these corners, you want to remove those corners. So what you do is you want to zoom up again, highest capacity, highest zoom that you can go. And you want to hit your eraser tool, and you want to, that's size that down a little bit. That's a little bit big. Go one more down. Okay. And start removing it. If you notice with this eraser tool, it has the little things to make it fit right in there. For the pixels. Let's get that going here. All right, go down around here. Just resize it all the way back down, zoom back down, and all the next thing you want to do is you want to put your text in as that I previously made the text, and here it is right here. You want to drag that in here, put it right there. Let's move this back, and as you see, you need to resize that. So let's take the size tool, click on that, and we want to do that like that. Let's do it like about right there, and that should be fine. But you want that to move that layer or the text all the way to the top. All right, then you want to take your move tool, you want to take and position it a little bit about right there. Okay, and then you want to take your perspective tool, which is right here, and you want to change the perspective. Click on it. And you want to narrow this down like that, narrow this up like that. You want to kind of like stay on that line right there to keep it in proportion. Okay, and then you want to up this as far as you want to up it. Let's go a little bit more. There you go. And then you can like move this up a little bit. Do it like that. And click transform, and as you see, there it is. And then you want to take this one more you have to put in that I had previously made. Where is that? Oh, here it is, right here. Take that and drag that in. There you go. Just hit the move tool so we can move that. Want to move it down some, and then we're gonna get the size tool. Get that correct size. Move that back over like that. And then hit scale. We're going to move that up a little bit. Make sure that it's in there. All right. And pretty much you're all done right here. And what you want to do is you want to now merge all visible layers. There you go, and as you can see, it turns everything into one layer, plus the background. Okay, now you want to do is just save it. Save. Okay, and how are we going to do this? BIWM dot PNG. Now you must save this as a PNG, or it won't come out that this cutout or background would be invisible. You would just have a, if you saved it like as a JPEG, it would be like still the white background back there. It won't be like invisible. It won't be like a cutout. So you must save it in a PNG. And, you can save it to your desktop or save it to anywhere in your computer you want to save it. So I'm just saving it to my pictures. Export. Save. And basically that's it. How I made my new watermark using GIMP. Hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you next time on another edition of the Technology and Gadget Show on BrownInktv. I'm your host, Mr. K, and I'm out of here. Bye-bye.